This is Sahithi on behalf of Edureka, and I welcome you to the session on installation and setting up of Automation Anywhere Enterprise Edition. Right? So in this session, guys, we'll see step by step how you can install and set up Automation Anywhere Enterprise Edition into your system. So let's get started. But before that, I would like to request all of you to subscribe to our Edureka YouTube channel to get daily notified on the top trending technologies. So on that note, let's start with today's session. So the topics for today's session are, as you can see on my screen, we'll first see how to set up and install SQL Server, and then I'll show you how you can set up your control room. Once both of them are done, we'll finally see how we can set up our Automation Anywhere client. So let's get started, guys. Now, before I start with the setting up and installation of Automation Anywhere, I would like to tell you one thing over here, that you know, Automation Anywhere Enterprise Edition can be either installed in the Express mode or the Custom mode. So we'll be going forward with the Express mode. I've chosen Express mode because, you know, I just want to install Enterprise Edition on my system, right? I don't want to install on, you know, like, let's say 100 systems or so. I just want to install on my system and I want the default configurations. But when we go for the custom mode is basically designed to install Automation Anywhere for an enterprise or maybe for a company where, you know, hundreds of PCs are using Automation Anywhere and the company wants few specific configurations. In that scenario, we go for the custom mode. But since in this session, we're just installing Enterprise Edition on our system, I'm going to choose for the Express mode. So when we choose Express mode to install Automation Anywhere, we'll be basically redirected to this particular link from where you can install Automation Anywhere Enterprise Edition. Now, this is the link from where you can download Automation Anywhere Enterprise Edition. So since I've already downloaded on my system, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use that particular file itself. So once you download Automation Anywhere, you'll basically see the zip file, right? So this particular zip file is downloaded and all the setup and the required configurations are compressed under this file. So what we'll do is you'll basically have to extract this file. Well, I've already done that too. So once I extract, that is this particular folder, which basically consists of compliance, installation documents and installation setup. And in installation setup, we basically have client and control room. But before that, as I said, you have to install and set up SQL Server. We also have SQL Server's folder over here, which is basically the setup folder from where you have to install. Now, to start installing SQL Server, what you basically have to do is you just have to double click on this particular icon. And once you double click on this particular icon, you'll basically see a dialog box which says that, you know, you have to choose the directory for the extracted files. So you can basically just choose the directory that is required. I've basically chosen C, users, and the username, documents, setup, and then the SQL Express Server. Right, so I'll just click on OK. And once I click on OK, you'll see a dialog box which will basically show the status of, you know, how many files are getting extracted. So we'll wait for that to happen. All right, now once the files are extracted, this is basically the dialog box which opens up. So it's basically the SQL Server Installation Center where you have basically two options. The first one is the new SQL Server standalone installation or to add features to an existing installation. And the second one is to upgrade from the existing SQL Server, that is 2005, 2008, 2008 R2 or 2012 version. So since we're installing for the first time, we'll just choose the first option, that is SQL Server standalone installation, right? So I'll just click over here. Now, once I click on that particular option, you'll see a dialog box, which will basically declare the license terms. So it's your wish, you can go forward and read the license terms. Well, I'm not going to do that presently. I'm just going to click on I accept the license terms radio button, and then I'll click on next. Once I click on next, we'll be basically redirected to the global rules page where, you know, all the rules will be checked, and then we'll go to the Microsoft update option. In that particular option, you don't have to check in anything, and then you just have to click on next, right? So I'll just click on next. And once I click on next, you'll be basically redirected to install setup files. Well, you see that, you know, all the setup files are getting installed, and then few of them will be completed and few of them will be skipped. Now, once that is also done, you'll go to install rules, and when install rules are also done automatically, the next one which comes is feature selection. So over here, what you have to do is you have to make sure that, you know, all your checkboxes are checked, and then you have to choose your instance root directory and the shared feature directory, right? Well, I'm going to keep it as it is. I'm not going to change any of them. And then what I'm going to do is I'll just click on next. Once I click on next, the next thing that we have to choose is feature rules. So over there, you have to basically give the name for your instance, right? So I'm just going to keep it SQL Express, which is by default, and the instance ID will be SQL Express, right? So with this particular instance ID, we'll understand that, you know, this is our server through which Automation Anywhere will be connected. Please remember that, you know, the instance ID name is SQL Express and the name of instance is also SQL Express. After that, we have the server directory. Now, once you think everything is fine over here, you just have to click on next again. Now, once you click on next, you'll be basically redirected to the server configuration, where you'll see the SQL Server database engine and the SQL Server browser. So here the startup type is automatic for the database engine, and then the browser is disabled by default. So I'll just keep it the way it is, and then I'll click on next. Now, once you click on next, the next thing that you have to configure is the database engine configuration. So over here, basically, we have two authentication modes, that is the Windows authentication mode and the mixed mode authentication mode. So I'll just choose the mixed mode authentication mode, and then we can mention the password. So I'll just mention the password over here. Right, so I'll enter the password, I'll confirm the password, and then this is basically the desktop to which our SQL Server is connected. And then what I'll do is I'll click on next. Now, once we click on next, automatically we see that, you know, feature configuration rules are done, and then the installation progress is shown. Let's just wait for that to happen. All right. Now, once the installation is done, you see a dialog box which opens up and says it's complete and your SQL Server 2014 installation has completed successfully. So over there, you can see various features that have been installed, like, you know, database engine services, SQL Server replication, the browser, the writer, the client connectivity SDK, and the support files. Now, once that is done, what you just have to do is you just have to check everything is fine or not, and then you can just click on close. Now, this is where your SQL Server installation completes, but yet you have to make sure that, you know, your system is connected to the SQL Server, right? So you basically have to enable the required services. So for that, what I'll do is I'll search for SQL Server configuration. So let me just search for SQL Server configuration app. And then what I'll do is I'll just double click over here. Now, once I click on the SQL Server configuration manager, this is basically the screen that opens up, right? Now, over here on the left side, you see various options like, you know, SQL Server services, the network configuration for 32-bit, the client configuration, the network configuration, and the protocols for SQL Express, right? So this is basically what we had configured, if you remember, right? The instance ID was SQL Express. So over here, what you have to do is you have to go over here, and then you see that, you know, the protocol name and the status on the right-hand side, that is basically that, you know, the shared memory is enabled, the name pipes is disabled, and the TCP IP are disabled, right? So what I'll do is I'll right click over here, I'll go to properties, and then I'll go for IP address over here, right? And what you have to do is you basically have to scroll down completely. And over here where you have the options of dynamic ports, you just have to mention the port number, that is 1433, right? So remember that, you know, the TCP IP port for SQL Server is basically 1433. Right, so this is what you have to mention over here, and then you just have to click on OK. Right, now after that, you again have to click on OK, and then what you do is you right click over here again, and then you make sure the TCP IP port is enabled. Right, now once TCP IP port is enabled, the next thing that you have to enable is the name pipes. So I'll again right click over here and choose enable. Now once it is enabled, the next thing that you have to do is you have to go to the SQL Server services option. And over here, you basically see three options, right? The SQL Server browser, the SQL Server for the instance ID, and the SQL Server agent for the instance ID. Over here, what you're going to do is you'll basically restart the service, right? So let me just restart this particular service. Now, once this service has restarted, the next thing that you have to check is basically where, you know, where your system is connected to SQL Server or not. So to do that, what you're going to do is you're going to go over here, right? And then you'll search for control panel. Right, and in control panel, you'll basically choose programs and features, right? So you'll go to programs over here, and then you'll choose programs and features. And then what you're going to do is you're going to choose this option of turn Windows features on or off, right? So I'll choose that. And then once I choose that, you see this dialog box opening up. So over here, you basically have to choose the Telnet client. So let's search for that. My Telnet client is already enabled, right? So just in case it's not enabled, you just have to check into this particular box. And then you have to click on OK. Now, once that is done, what you'll do is you'll go to command prompt. And over here, you'll basically type telnet localhost. And you'll mention the port number, that is 1433. Now, once you see that, you know, this particular output is shown, that is connecting to localhost, and it just vanishes, that means that, you know, your SQL Server is connected to our system. So this is where, guys, the SQL Server installation ends. I hope you've understood how you can install SQL Server. Well, it's really simple to install, guys. What you have to first do is you have to extract all the files from the Automation Anywhere folder and then put it in some file. After that, you have to just choose the SQL Server application and then double click on that. And then from there, you'll see that, you know, the files will be extracted. After that, you'll choose the option for new standalone installation, where you'll just accept the license agreements and then you'll just keep clicking on next. The two most important things that you have to understand over here is that, you know, you have to check the root directory for SQL Server, and also you have to check the instance name and the instance ID. Now, once both of them are checked, you just keep clicking on next, and then you'll see that, you know, the installation is done. Once the installation is done, you have to make sure that, you know, your SQL Server is restarted, right? So for that, you'll go to the SQL Server Configuration Manager, and in the protocol section, you'll basically go to the TCP/IP section, where you'll right click over there, go to properties and mention the port number in the dynamic port section. In the dynamic port section, that is 1433, and then you'll enable both the named pipes and the TCP/IP. After that, you'll go to the SQL Services section, and then over there, you'll basically restart the SQL Server service. And then finally, to check whether your system is connected to SQL Server or not, you'll enable the Telnet client, and then in the command prompt, you'll mention Telnet localhost and the port number, that is 1433. So that was about installation of SQL Server, guys. I hope you've understood. Now let's just close all these windows so that there's no confusion, right? And let's move forward and install Enterprise Edition. That is basically where you'll set up the control room. So for that, what I'll do is I'll right click over here, choose Run as Administrator. Now, once we choose Run as Administrator, we see this dialog box which says preparing to install. So let's wait for that to happen. Now, once that is done, you get this option of, you know, unsupported OS detected. You see a message that, you know, Automation Anywhere Enterprise is currently not supported on this OS. But yet, if you want to continue your installation, some features might not work, right? So we just want to continue our installation. So we'll just click on yes over here. And then what will happen is that, you know, you'll see a dialog box which says, welcome to installation wizard for Automation Anywhere Enterprise. So for this particular wizard, you just have to click on next. And then you see that, you know, you have to accept the license agreements, right? So I'll just click on I accept the license agreements. Well, you can go forward and read the agreements. Well, I'm not going to do that for this particular session. And then I'll click on next. Once I click on next, you see option of, you know, express installation and custom mode installation. Well, these are two types of installation modes that you can use, right? So since I've told you before also that, you know, I'll be going forward with the express installation, I'm just going to choose the express installation for a quick installation with default configurations. But if you want to manually configure various stuff and then you want to use Automation Anywhere for production usage, you can go forward and choose the custom mode. But for this session, as I said before, I'm going to go for the express mode. So I'm just going to click on next over here. Now, once I click on next, the next thing that you see is the database server configuration. As you see on my screen, the database port number is 1433 that we had configured before. And then the name of the control room database will be CRDB new, and the name of the bot inside database will be bot inside. Over here, there are again two authentication modes, Windows and SQL Server. Well, I'm going to go forward with the Windows one. After that, I'll just click on next. So please remember that, you know, you have to make sure that, you know, all these details are correct, and then you're fine with all the details present, because once you install, you cannot change these details. So the control room database will be CRDB new, and the bot inside database will be bot inside. So after that, I'll click on next. Now, once we click on next, we see an option as ready to install the program, right? So if you're fine with all the details mentioned before, you can just go forward and click on install. But otherwise, if you want to just check again, you can choose the option of back. Go back and check all the details and then come back and choose the option of install. So I'm just going to choose the option of install over here. All right. Now, once I click on the option of install, you can see that, you know, my installation wizard has started installing Automation Anywhere Enterprise Edition. So let's just wait for that to happen. All right. Now, once the installation is complete, you see this wizard which says, you know, installation shield wizard completed. And then you get two checkboxes where, you know, you can choose either to launch the Automation Anywhere Enterprise and show the installer settings, right? So I'm just going to check in the first box, that is a launch Automation Anywhere Enterprise, and then I'm going to click on finish. Now, once I click on finish, you'll see that, you know, automatically Automation Anywhere Enterprise will be launched, right? So you can see that control room is getting launched, right? So let's just wait for that to happen. All right. So once the control room is launched, you see that, you know, the control room administrator page opens up, where you have to mention the username, the first name, email, password, and so on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the first username to be admin, because that person will be admin, and then first name to be, let's say, trainer. That is my desktop name. Email to be, let's say, my email ID. Right. And then I'll just confirm the mail. After that, I'll mention the password. So let me just mention the password. Okay, it says 6 to 5 characters with capitals, alphabets, numbers, and then symbols, right? So I'll just mention. Now, once that is done, what I'll do is I'll just click on next. Now, once you click on next, what you see is that, you know, you have to basically create security questions just in case, you know, you forget your password and so on, right? So I'll just mention what is your company name, and I'll mention the answer. I'll just mention the next question, which is what are the random numbers you choose? I'll mention the answer, and then let's say most common symbol. I'll just mention the answer over here. Right, and then what I'll do is I'll just click on next. Now, once we click on next, this is the next thing that you have to configure, that is basically the credential settings. So the credential settings basically has a credential vault master key, which allows you to connect to the credential vault where you can create and store credentials that are required when running the bots. So you basically have to save the master key now in a safe place for future reference. So since I've installed automation anywhere on express mode, I'll choose express mode, and then I'll just copy this particular master key. And let's say, you know, I open Notepad, and then I'll just paste the master key, right? And then I'll just save this particular file, right? So let's say, you know, I save this particular file to desktop, and let's mention master, right? And then I'll click on save. Then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to choose this option of save and login. So I'm just going to log into my control room. So let's just wait for it to open. Once you log into your control room with the admin credentials, this is basically how your control room looks, where, you know, you have this option of administration, and in the administration, you can go and check your configuration URLs, that is basically your control room URLs, right? So let's just wait for that to happen. Let's just wait for it to load. All right, so let's just click on administration now. In administration over here, I'll just click on settings, and in settings, I'll just choose general. And then if I choose general, you see the general settings that, you know, installation type is express. And the control room access URL is basically this particular URL. So guys, this is basically the URL you have to use to log into your client. Now, before that, I would like to tell you, don't worry if you're confused about the different features in control room. I'll be coming up with one more session on Automation Anywhere control room, where I'll talk about all these features in depth. Until then, let's move forward and see how we can set up our client. So we'll go back to our folders. And in our folders, what I'll do is I'll go back to documents over here. And then I'll choose this particular folder, go over here, go to installation setup, go to client. And then in the client, I basically have two options. That is the Automation Anywhere Enterprise client and application and the second one. So we're going to choose the first one. And then I'll just right click over here and choose run as administrator. Now, once I choose it to be run as administrator, you see an installation wizard, which has started extracting all the files. And then the installation will start soon, right? So let's just wait for that to happen. Now, once the installation begins, you see a welcome to setup wizard for Automation Anywhere Enterprise client. Since we want to set up the enterprise client, what I'll do is I'll click on next. And once I click on next, you see this dialog box of, you know, license agreement, right? So you can just go forward and read the license agreement. Over here, I'm not going to do. I accept the license agreement, radio button, and then I'll click on next. Once I click on next, you basically have to choose the destination folder to download the enterprise client. So this is what I've put by default, that is C, program files, and then Automation Anywhere and Enterprise. And then I'll just click on next. Once I click on next, you see a few options which can be installed. Like, you know, the desktop icon will be created and the plugin installation will be for i11, Chrome, and Edge. After that, I'll just click on install. And once I click on install, you'll see that, you know, automatically Automation Anywhere Enterprise client will start getting installed. So let's just wait for that to happen. All right. Now, once the installation is done, you see a setup wizard that which says setup wizard complete, and then we can launch Automation Anywhere Enterprise client, right? So for that, you just have to check into this particular radio button and then you click on finish. Once you click on finish, you'll automatically see that, you know, the client will start getting launched, right? So let's wait for the client to be launched and then we'll log into the client. Now, you can fetch the control room URL from the general settings of the control room. And then what you can do is you can just choose this option of Windows authentication or user credentials. And then you can mention the username and the password. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a user first, right? So for that, what I'll do is I'll go back to my control room, right? And then what I'll do is I'll go to users over here, right? In users, what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose this option of create user, right? So I'll just click on create user, and then I'll mention user one, let's say name to be Sahithi, then I'll mention the password, and then I'll confirm the password, right? And then I'll mention email ID. Right, and then what I'll do is I'll just scroll down, and over here, once you create the user, you have to select a role for the user. So over here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose this role of AA basic, and then I'll just add it over here, right? So that means that, you know, this particular role has been added to this particular user. Well, it's not necessary that, you know, only one particular role has to be selected for a user. You can select any number of roles that you want, right? So over here, I'm just selecting one particular role, and then what I'll do is I'll go down and allocate a device license to this particular user. So for now, I'm choosing bot creator, and then I'll scroll up, and then you can just check all the details. So over here, I forgot to confirm the email ID. So I'll just confirm the email ID. I've mentioned the password, the first name, let's say Sahithi, right? And the username is user1, and the role is AE basic, and the device license is bot creator, right? So after that, I'll just click on create user. Now, since our user has been created, what I'll next do is I'll go back to my client login, and I'll choose this option of user credentials. And over here, I'll mention username and the password, right? Now, once the password is mentioned, I'll just click on login, and you'll see that, you know, automatically the user with the user credentials user1 will be logged into our client, right? So let's wait for that to happen, right? So we'll just get started. Now, once the user has been logged in, this is basically the dashboard that the user sees. That is basically our Automation Anywhere Enterprise client. And now, in this particular client, a user can automate from simple to complex tasks. Well, I'm not going to go into depth of that because this session was based on installation and setup of Automation Anywhere. So if you want to learn and practice various examples in Automation Anywhere, then you can refer to my session on Automation Anywhere examples. Apart from this, if you want to get an in-depth understanding of Automation Anywhere control room, then stay tuned, as we'll be releasing a session very soon for Automation Anywhere control room, where I'll be giving an in-depth idea of all the features present in the control room. So until then, that's all from our side today. I hope you found this session informative, and I hope you've understood how you can install and set up Automation Anywhere Enterprise Edition. So that's all from my side today. Thank you and happy learning.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!